Open Lands is one of the first metropolitan conservation organizations in the United States. And so we look at the quality of ecological restoration projects in three different ways. We look at the economic impact of this restoration. Here in Palatine, they saw an ROI for every dollar invested in this restoration project. They saw in the short term a $2 return in the economic development of their community. In the long term, they saw a $6 return. And in recreation, they saw over $14 million yearly.
Whether you're a corporation engaged in sustainability, whether you're a nonprofit organization, whether you're a community looking to enhance your public natural spaces, investment in nature, improvement in biodiversity for the benefit of human well-being is just good business. We're at historic Deer Grove Forest Preserve. Deer Grove Forest Preserve is located in the city of Palatine. We're about 30 miles northwest of downtown Chicago.
Well, the history of this site is what a lot of people don't know. This is the first parcel that the Forest Preserve bought back in 1915. I think it's really exciting that we were able to do this project on this particular site.
Well, one of the reasons that we liked this site was it had so many diverse habitats. There were woodlands, there were savannas, a bur oak savanna, which is globally rare, wetlands, wooded wetlands, prairies.
So Deer Grove Forest Preserve covers about 2,000 acres, and our project site covered about 650 acres of that. So the thing that got me excited about this project was really just seeing the vast potential for ecosystem recovery across the project footprint. Our client on this was Open Lands. They're a leading nonprofit conservation organization here in Chicago. They've been championing projects like this throughout the region for over 50 years, and they weren't really the only partner involved. It was a whole team of partners that made this project a success. So Open Lands, the Forest Preserves of Crook County, the landowner, and last but not least, the Deer Grove Natural Area Volunteers.
The partnership between Open Lands, Stantec, and the Forest Preserve has been very fruitful. Working together with these organizations and companies that really know what they're doing, very professional about their work, really brought us a long way.
The community was facing challenges in that parts of the Forest Preserve were not accessible to them. But there were areas where, especially in the woodlands, that were so degraded and so closed off and so brush invaded that people felt unsafe. It's surrounded by houses. So when we do this restoration and we're going to create wetlands, does it mean they're going to have more flooding or less flooding? This is a heavily used site, and we wanted to do the restoration without having to close down the site. So we were able to do this project in full public view. How do we manage people's expectations? How do we keep public support when we are doing the type of work that we do?
We're always looking at the ecological quality. So at Deer Grove East, you can't get much higher than that. We had a 300% increase in floristic quality. It's at 94.7 right now. So when you look at Deer Grove East, this is the highest you can probably be in our region, and it's a model for ecological restoration. We also look at the impact to the community. Is there greater usage? Do people feel safer being in the forest preserves? Are they enjoying themselves more? And as you walk across this forest preserve, you see there's been an increase in attendance on the trails, bikers, joggers, people walking their dogs, and just enjoying the calm they feel while being here.
So what's innovative about the Stantec adaptive management approach is that we really take the mindset of managing a site like our own backyard. We've had a motto over the years, leave a site better than you found it. So a full delivery nature-based approach is beneficial to our clients because it's a streamlined way for our clients to access all of our professional services from the multiple phases that are involved with ecosystem restoration, from the early phases of a baseline assessment and planning and design through permitting and implementation and construction, all the way through that long-term maintenance and monitoring. Instead of a client having to work with multiple contractors or entities at each phase, Stantec can provide that throughout the life course of a project. Oftentimes you can find it to be a cost savings for our clients while providing a really high quality work product.
I wanted to see how can volunteers and contractors and staff all work together in a constructive way. Volunteers are extremely important to the success of the project.
We collect seed every fall, and we then provide the seed to Stantec, and they would use that seed to replenish some of the more degraded areas where they've been doing restoration work. Well, ecological restoration is a long-term undertaking. And the ecosystems that we're restoring here will be more resilient to the encroachment of invasive plants, climate change, and other disturbances.
So listening to land is important because nature tells you when you're doing something well and when you're not doing something well. So it's important to listen to those cues and use things like adaptive management to adjust your course of action as you move forward.
Restoration is sort of like surgery. It looks kind of rough when you're first doing it, but once it heals, time goes by, looks spectacular, and that's what we have today.